Stanford certainly has its share of accolades and awards, but the Guinness World Records, well, that may be a first.
Hey, Euan. I know you're short on time because time is of the essence. Tell me about this world record in the fastest genome sequencing.
Well, we set out to try and sequence a genome faster than anyone ever had, because for little babies in the neonatal intensive care unit, it really matters whether you can get the answer in 5 hours, 10 hours, or as it currently is, you know, several weeks or months.
Minutes could save lives, right?
When little babies or teenagers or adults are critically ill, you need answers in minutes, you need answers in hours, and there isn't time to wait weeks or months to get a genome sequencing test. So we set out to do it faster, and using this machine right here and this team right here, we managed to break the world record for the fastest human genome ever sequenced. Well, to do this as fast as we needed to do, the team had to be here all day and sometimes even all night. Just as an example, here is John's sleeping bag.
So how does it feel to be a world record holder?
Yeah, it's kind of a little unbelievable and a little surreal. I used to watch the TV show of the Guinness World Records growing up, and so I think we're often fascinated by people at the extremes. I think we here are fascinated by pushing those extremes, but doing it for the benefit of humankind.
So the faster the technology, the faster you'll get to the finish line in saving patients' lives.
The faster we can sequence the genome, the faster we can analyze the data, the faster we get an answer, provide the answer for the doctors in order to save the patient's life.
Congratulations. You are officially amazing.